It's time for the match game, Hollywood Square. Our quiz from Three's Company, Richard Klein. From Too Close for Comfort, Lydia Cornell. From Days of Our Lives, Gloria Loring. Marty Cohen. Edie McClure. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Square's Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
Welcome one and all to the Match Game, Hollywood Square's Hour. This is a marriage of two of your favorite TV games. I'll be hosting the Match Game.
And later on, I'm going to be handling Hollywood Squares.
Say, why don't we get down to work right now and find a seat over here on the aisle. It costs you $12.50. Have a seat there. Hello, stars.
How are you?
Thank you. Some of you I am seeing for the very first time, and I want to give you a warm greeting here and make you feel at home in our house.
Well,
do you feel at home?
I feel very at home. In fact, I have my shoes off at this very moment.
You do?
Yes, and I'm going to be in your refrigerator in a second, so.
Nice to see your buddy.
Thank you.
I'll be sitting up here.
Yes. Are you ready to greet our civilians and have a go at it over here?
So.
All right, then let's welcome Phil White and Suzanne Hathaway. Welcome. Now, let's get acquainted. Phil, please tell us a little bit about you.
Well, I'm originally from New York City.
Yeah.
And I'm a salesman for an ice cream company out here. Yeah. And in my spare time, I like to ride my motorcycle.
All right. Suzanne, let's hear about you.
Hi. I'm very glad to see you all.
Cool. She's glad to see you.
Yeah.
Are you glad to see her?
Okay. When I'm not here, I'm working for a savings and loan. And when I'm not working, I'm also going to school at night at Cal State Fullerton. I'm a business major, and I should be graduating probably in about a year.
All right. Good luck in that venture, and good luck here. Now, on the match game, the object is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. We'll play three rounds. The contestants match the most celebrities at the end of the game. We'll go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. So let's get to round one here. Phil, you won the toss, so you have a chance, a choice of A or B.
I'll take A, please.
A is what he gets, because that's what he wants. At the Olympics.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. One high jumper said to the other, "When you jump over the bar, be careful. Somebody fill the landing pit with blank." At the Olympics, one high jumper said to the other, "When you jump over the bar, be careful, because somebody fill the landing pit with blank."
Oh, ouch.
That's good. Just slide it right there. There you go. That lights up your light.
So painful to think of.
Okay, lower tier is ready. Here we go, Phil. At the Olympics, one high jumper said to the other, "When you jump over the bar, be careful, because somebody filled the landing pit with..."
Cement.
Cement. That would hurt.
Ouch.
Because it's hard. It would be difficult whether it was dried out and hard or whether it was still gooey, wouldn't it, Lydia?
That's an awful illusion, but I have quicksand.
Quicksand. Jump over, break the world's record, and nobody ever hears from you again.
One way to get rid of the competition. I'll try that next time. Actually, it's tax.
Tax, that would hurt. Very painful. What say you, Sir Richard?
I don't know, but I think I want to put Lydia on my Christmas tree. Hurt me. I obviously wasn't listening to the question, Gene, and so I have a ridiculous answer which does not match Phil. And I'm sorry, I said whipped cream.
Whipped cream. Oh, that'd be good.
I think that's
a good answer there. All right. When you jump over the bar, be careful because somebody filled a landing pit with...
I'm with Edie. Thumbtacks.
We have two of those so far, Phil. All right. Phil is looking for a little cement over here. Well, do you have some cement for him, Gloria?
I would love... what I have is a lot of little cements. It's rocks.
Rocks. That would hurt.
A little hard.
All of these are good responses, but no match so far, Phil.
Isn't this the official game show of the U.S. Olympic team?
It is, yes.
I was close to those guys. I said nails.
Nails. All right.
Sorry, Phil.
Your answer was good, and they had a lot of good answers over there, too, but no match. Now, let's see how Suzanne does with her first-round question. Hey, did you hear about the strange thing that happened on The Price is Right? Did
no.
you hear about that?
What happened?
Oh, well, let me tell you. All of the contestants refused to bid on an all-expense-paid trip to blank. Oh. Ready? Upper tier. You're ready. All right, here we go. Suzanne, the strange thing that happened on The Price is Right, all of the contestants refused to bid on an all-expense-paid trip to...
Tijuana.
Tijuana. Yeah. Why do you say Tijuana, Suzanne?
I don't know. That was the first thing that came to my mind.
All right, well, that's the way to play this game. First thing that comes to your mind. Tijuana, eh? What do you say, Lydia?
Well, I was going to say Beirut, Lebanon, because I was there last year, but Grenada.
Grenada. Yes. A lot of people would refuse to go there these days. What do you say, ma'am?
Beirut, Lebanon.
Aha. All right.
That's a very good...
good response. Richard?
South of the border.
Aha! One for Suzanne.
Hey, Richard.
He said Tijuana. Same thing she said. Refused to bid on an all-expense-paid trip to...
Well, it's funny. The first thing that came to my mind was, in fact, Tijuana.
It was.
But then I thought, nobody will say Tijuana. That's crazy. So I figured home is where the heart is. Burbank.
Burbank. Of beautiful downtown fame.
Here we are.
Gloria.
Now, you sat there and looked over my shoulder and said, no, go with your... And I thought this is a real... There are people who I know who live in this city who are going to think I'm awful, but I'm a W.C. Fields fan, and I said Philadelphia.
That's what W.C. Fields would have said.
That's what he
On the whole,
said.
I'd rather be
but
in
I'm
Philadelphia.
In trouble now.
It's all right.
Maybe we're not on in Philadelphia.
The show doesn't go to
you
Philadelphia.
Won't be now. You know what? I figured nobody would want to go here because they not only lose your luggage, they lose you. I said the Bermuda Triangle.
The Bermuda Triangle. Interesting answers. Okay, there's round one, 1-0 in Suzanne's favor. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Right now, this for you. Here we go. Thank you. Round two coming up. Let's get right to it here. And Suzanne, since you're ahead, you go first. Do you want A or B?
How about B? Yeah.
All right, I've got it. Crazy Norman was arrested by the undersea police.
Uh-oh.
Let me tell you about this.
The undersea.
He was arrested by the undersea police.
Undersea.
After he tried to blank a mermaid.
Crazy what? I didn't hear.
Crazy Norman. It's just an arbitrary fellow that we chose. All right. I guess we're ready up there, and we're ready down here.
What?
Suzanne, Crazy Norman was arrested by the undersea police after he tried to blank a mermaid.
How about frisk a mermaid?
Frisk?
Chicken.
That will be difficult because, you see, Suzanne, you couldn't say to a mermaid, okay, up against the wall and spread them. She can't do that, can she?
No. Not very easy.
That was also a chicken of the sea answer.
What do you say, Lydia?
Ride a mermaid.
Ride a mermaid, yes.
Like ride a
Yeehaw.
Whale.
Yeah,
for sure, like they do at SeaWorld in San Diego and all that. What do you say?
Oh, a real logic flaw here.
A logic flaw? Uh-oh, we have a logic flaw.
A real logic flaw.
Does not compute. Does not compute.
Drown
a mermaid, yes. See, that's very difficult.
Oh, you're right, Edie.
They can breathe underwater right. Or on top of the water. You don't do that. So, John, we come to you.
Oops.
After you tried to blank a mermaid. You tried
trip
to trip
a mermaid.
Trip a mermaid. Fix that down there, would you, Marty? Okay.
I'll get that for you,
yeah. Thank you very much.
It was a feather.
John, what yes. are they, Crazy Norman, what did he try to do to this mermaid?
Well, I enjoy fish very much, and she is half one, so I said, cook.
Oh. Oh. Terrible.
Poor
lady.
Sorry, Charlie.
Gloria.
Well, I went for something just a little more risque. Undress a mermaid.
Aha! What was she wearing?
Scales.
Aha! He tried to scale a mermaid.
But he was crazy, right? He was crazy.
Yes,
Norman.
He was crazy, right.
Crazy Norman.
Marty, how crazy was he?
Well, you see, I'm a newlywed. So that's where my mind is. And have you ever heard the expression to deflower a virgin?
Yes.
A mermaid, you would defin.
Defin.
Right. That's the okay.
Defin. All right. Now, Suzanne, you stay at one. Phil, you have a chance to catch up a little bit here with this one. Zappo the Punk said, "If you think I'm strange looking, you should see my girlfriend. She just dyed her hair to match her blank."
Ow!
Is it?
This is a punk fellow talking. Okay. All right, we're all set. Phil, we come to you. Zappo the Punk said, "If you think I'm strange looking, you should see my girlfriend. She just dyed her hair to match her
couch."
Or couch. Yeah, well, that is strange, isn't it? Lydia, he said couch. What do you say?
This is probably just the same as his couch car.
Car. All right.
That's
good. His is good. Yours is good. No doubt yours will be good. What?
Dog.
Dog. Uh-huh. Very good. All good responses. Now... Yes, sir.
Well, Gene, Zappo's girlfriend was into horticulture.
Horticulture.
Right. And
right.
I'm not going to touch that, and neither are you.
No, right.
So I said she would dye her hair to match her front lawn.
Her front lawn. How hip. Would be green or something like that.
Incredibly hip.
Yes.
Once again, ladies.
You should see my girlfriend. She just dyed her hair to match her what, John?
Yes, well, these are shiny and metallic and usually odd colors. I said car.
Car, right. Oddball color, right.
And I also said car.
Uh-huh.
Well,
several of those.
That's a great answer, Phil.
Yes.
Remember.
You're lucky because I didn't say car, Phil.
How
but
lucky
you're
is
not
he?
So lucky because I said plaid skirt.
A plaid skirt.
A lot of colors.
So. Got a tight game going here. 1-0 at the end of round 2. Suzanne is still in the lead. Let's see what happens in the final round right after this. Here we go. Round 3. This is the final round. Suzanne, it's still 1-0. You're ahead, and therefore you have to go first.
Okay, I'd like B again.
B. What does B say? B says...
He says...
Tough Tina is so tough.
How tough is she?
Thank you. Here's how tough she is. When her nose gets shiny, she powders it with blank powder. That's how tough she is.
Thanks. That helps a lot.
I thought so.
This is,
In the event that Miss Loring has an actual answer, she'll be forced to...
Here we go. Tough Tina's so tough, Suzanne.
I'm sorry.
When her nose gets shiny, she powders it with blank powder.
How about gunpowder?
Gunpowder? Gunpowder. Wow, don't smoke around Tough Tina. What do you say?
I'm going to shoot you. Gunpowder.
Gunpowder. Don't point that thing at me. All right. Oh, there it is. That's 2. All right. You've got everybody in the upper tier now. Suzanne, let's see how you do down here. John, Tough Tina, powders her nose with...
Your score is exploding, Suzanne.
All right. You're up to 4. Gloria.
Oh, I finally did something right. Gun.
You got it. 5. You make it a perfect 6.
I can't believe that was such an obvious answer, and then I went ahead and said it. Gun.
Uh-huh. Well, there were some other possibilities, you know, scouring powder or, you know, any of those abrasive-type powders.
Powder.
Now, Phil, the best you can do is achieve a tie. To do that, you must match everyone. And here we go.
Oh,
here we go.
On.
When Peter the Picker picked all the crops in the field, he went into the farmer's house and picked the farmer's blank. He picked all the crops in the field.
Crop.
Then he went into the farmer's house and picked the farmer's blank. Already over there. Okay, here we go. Phil. When Peter the Picker picked all the crops in the field, he went into the farmer's house and picked the farmer's blank.
Pockets.
Pockets. Good. He picked the farmer's pockets. You need 6 pockets over here, Phil, to achieve a tie and stay in the game. The first time we trip up, it'll be a victory for your opponent. Go, Lydia.
I was going to say wife, but I decided it did rhyme.
Farmer's pick the daughter. Farmer's daughter. So Suzanne wins the game. Come on down, Suzanne. All right. Right here, if you would, please. We're going to have a go at the Hollywood Square as part of it later. We congratulate Suzanne. And we're going to say goodbye to Phil White. We're going to have some gifts coming your way. Many thanks for being here on the Match Game. Phil White. There we go. Well, how do you feel?
Good.
Now, Suzanne, it's time to switch to the Hollywood Squares Hour. We're going to have 3 more celebrities make an entrance here in a moment or so. They're bringing the rest of the furniture in here, and there it is. I'm going to change places with John Bauman, the host of Hollywood Squares. So, friends, a lot more excitement coming up. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Sierra Online Action Games, and the home computer includes Frogger and the classic Space Game Threshold. Designed for family fun, furnished by Sierra Online. And now, it's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Square. Our with from Trapper John, MD, Brian Mitchell. Jamie Widow. Paul Provenza. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
And we'll be right back, you two.
Now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. Welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, and I have Suzanne Hathaway, who has survived the Match Game competition. I also have 3 new celebrities, Jamie, Brian, and Paul. Paul Provenza.
Mr. Bauman.
Yeah, this is your first time playing either of these illustrious, time-honored games, Paul?
Certainly, I've played the home game many times, but that's about it.
Well,
I actually
ought to
have
help.
Celebrities come to my home, and we play.
Well, it's great having you here, I think.
It's great to be here.
Okay, we are now ready to take on the returning champion in Hollywood Square, Suzanne. Let's go. And here is our returning champion. Her name is Lisa Gold. Lisa. You got a nice hand. Why don't you refresh our memories? Tell us a little bit about yourself in 25 words or less.
I live in Santa Monica, California. I'm an aspiring musical theater performer, and hopefully will make my way to Broadway very soon.
Okay. Well, you got a good start at getting to Broadway. I think a plane ticket costs less than $2,600, and that's what you have so far on our show. Okay, we're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever is ahead at that time is the winner, goes on to play our super match for up to $30,000. Now, our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that either of you should capture. Our champion has the privilege of starting. That is you, Lisa. Pick a square.
I'd like Edie, please.
Edie McClurg. In a Psychology Today survey of vacations, Edie, which of these fantasy trips was the most popular? Spending a year in a foreign country, or being marooned on a tropical island with several members of the opposite sex?
Several members. We can't denote, say, Namath or any of those guys.
Jamie took his place.
A year in a foreign country.
Right. Or being marooned on a tropical island with several members of the opposite sex.
This is a fantasy vacation.
Mm-hmm.
I think people will think twice about something like that, and I always need a 7-Eleven or a library nearby, so I'm going to go for the year in a foreign country.
Okay. I don't know if you can find a 7-Eleven in a foreign country, but we'll soon find out. She says a year in a foreign country would be preferable to most people. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I'll agree.
A year in a foreign country it is. You are right to agree. You get the first square and $25.
Get these people.
How's it going? Okay, Suzanne, she's got a big X on the board. Where would you like to move?
About Jamie.
Okay,
Suzanne.
Jamie Widows. Who took in more money in 1982, Jamie? Exxon Oil or the Internal Revenue Service?
In fact, it was in Fortune magazine, and it's Exxon.
Okay, Jamie says Exxon took in more than the Internal Revenue. Agree or disagree, Suzanne?
I agree.
The Internal Revenue Service took in more money. No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent
Fortune
gets
magazine.
My goodness, how could you do that to her?
Jamie,
wait a second. The Internal Revenue Service took in $600 billion of our dollars. Exxon only took in $100 billion.
My goodness.
I know they got about $50 billion.
Keep your cards and letters coming.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, Lisa, your move.
I'll take Marty Cohen to win, please.
Right. Marty Cohen to win. You get this one, you win the first game,
$100. Is this heavy pressure, John?
Marty. Who's been around longer, Marty? Howard Cosell or the electric dental drill?
Aha. This is perfect for me because in college, I majored in dentistry with a minor in big mouth sportscasters. And, actually, Mr. Cosell is... He's not a young fellow, and of course, then again, teeth aren't real new either. I'm going to have to say, I believe, because I know this, that, and I'm sure of this now.
No, I'm just, more and more all the time, right?
I'm sure, in fact.
He just likes to be on camera a whole long time, that's all.
That's right, Gloria, so stop shaking up the action. I'm going to say the truth, and that is that Howard Cosell has actually been around longer.
Okay.
He's about 60-something, so he's been around longer.
Marty says Howard Cosell's been around longer than the electric dental drill. Agree or disagree for the game, Lisa?
I'll disagree.
The answer is the electric dental drill. You're right to disagree. You win the game. We didn't know. Okay, congratulations, Lisa. You've won our first game. You have $175 so far. Not enough for you, Suzanne, but we will be right back to play our $200 game. Stay with us.
For more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Our next game is going to be worth $200 and $25 for every square that you capture. Lisa, you won the last game. You have $175 so far. Suzanne, you have nothing so far, but you do win the privilege of starting this game. Pick a square.
Okay, Edie, please.
Okay.
Edie again. You're about to have your first date with a guy you really like. When he arrives to pick you up, Edie, you notice that his fly is open.
Ah.
Oh, portent of great doings, I guess.
I guess I could throw away this question. She seems... No, there's more to this.
Oh.
According to 17 Magazine, you notice that his fly is open. Should you ignore it? Should you tell him about it? Or should you zip it up for him?
Well, let's see. Where are we going afterward? All right. I'll tell you, 17 Magazine will tell you the polite and proper thing to do. And I remember reading about this article. You know, it was various portions of clothing and what to do with them. It was a grand article. I enjoyed it. I read it every night. And what they would tell you to do is to tell him about it. It's cruel to leave a person with their clothing open.
A popular answer. Also, a lot of people in the audience seem to be saying something to their neighbors. Okay, Suzanne.
Yeah.
Edie says that you should tell him that his fly is open. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You should tell him about it. You are right to agree, and you get the first square. Okay, Lisa, pick a star for me.
I'd like Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene.
Yes.
The resort town of Bar Harbor, Maine.
Yes.
Has a population of 3,500 people and 700,000 what? Is it pigeons, laboratory mice, or sardines?
They can't be pigeons. There aren't that many pigeons. There isn't that great a fishing industry up there. It's a resort town. So pigeons are eliminated. What are the other two things?
Laboratory mice or sardines?
Or flies.
Well, there are no laboratories because all them rich folk live up there in the summertime. So it can't be laboratory mice. By sheer logic, deductive reasoning, I say sardines.
Okay. Lisa Jean says that Bar Harbor, Maine has several hundred thousand sardines. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
It has several hundred thousand laboratory mice. You are right to disagree, and you get the square.
John, I think she has tremendous courage to disagree with Jean, because I never would have disagreed with an answer that definitively.
It was awfully convincing, wasn't it?
Was he convincing?
Okay, Suzanne, your move.
Richard Klein.
Richard.
There are 700,000 laboratory mice and one very frightened elephant. Go ahead.
In the Naked City. Richard.
Yes, John.
You're a good stud bull.
I beg your pardon?
Says here you're a good stud bull.
A stud bull?
Mm-hmm. That's what it says. You're a good... Listen, it's a compliment. Take it. You're a good stud bull. How many cows can you service? About one a day or one an hour?
He wants to see the cow first.
It depends on my record collection, actually. If I got a complete set of Mantovani, it's one an hour. All those people do, and people, all those guys do, those stud bulls, they eat and they, so I would say one an hour.
Okay, so. Richard and the audience prefer the more active stud bull, one an hour. Agree or disagree, Suzanne?
I'll agree.
No, they can only service one a day. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the square.
You know what, John? The problem is they need to play more records. He's talking about. They need to play Bolero, and then they'll have a great time.
Bolero. Okay, Lisa, if you have survived that quip.
Yeah, no, nobody's asking me anything right now. I think I just found out why.
You should take a good look at the board and pick a square for me.
I'd like Marty Cohen, please.
Mm-hmm. Marty.
Yes, John.
Which will more likely cause a backache if you wear it too long? A necktie that's too tight or high-heeled shoes?
I can't even believe you're asking me these questions because, you know, in college I majored in chiropractic. And,
it's dentistry.
With a minor in footwear. And, what was the question, John?
I don't know. Which will cause a backache if you wear it too long? More likely, necktie that's too tight or high-heeled shoes?
Oh, the shoes. Absolutely.
Okay. Lisa, Marty says that high-heeled shoes will cause a backache more likely. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
And it is high-heeled shoes. You're right to agree, and you get the square. How does she do it? Well done. Suzanne, better take a good look at the board and make your move.
Yeah, well, how about Gloria?
Gloria to block.
Pressure's on.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
She gets this, she blocks. However, if she misses this, Lisa wins yet another game. Gloria, you're a divorced mother with a child. According to Joyce Brothers, is it okay to introduce your dates to your child, or should you wait till you're ready for a relationship?
Well, I think good manners would dictate that you would introduce your dates to your children. They are a part of your family and a part of your home, and if they are going to be coming and going, I would say absolutely.
Okay, so she says you should introduce your dates to your child. Agree or disagree, Suzanne? To block.
I'll disagree.
It's okay to introduce them to the kid. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins another game. Well, Lisa, you got $475 so far. Only $25 so far, Suzanne, but there's still time. We'll have time to play another game, at least right after this. $475 for Lisa, $25 for Suzanne, one a day for the stud bull. Okay, Suzanne.
Thank you, John.
You lost the last game. That means you get to start this one. There's a silver lining. Pick a square.
Okay, Edie, please.
Oh, surprise, surprise.
They love to start with you, Edie McClurg. In ancient Rome, who took care of the house and the kids, the husband or the wife?
In ancient Rome, did they have children then?
Suppose they must have. We're here, aren't we?
Yeah. Oh.
Paul Provenza's here, sure they do.
Let's see. In ancient Rome, who took care of the home? Men? I would say the house and kids.
Yeah. Who took care of the house and kids, the husband or the wife?
Well.
This is a toughie.
This is a tough
I think
quest.
She's saying they took care of themselves, the house and kids.
Flip a coin, Edie.
It is. These are the.
Look it up.
You didn't know I spoke Latin. All right.
Not till this minute. It's an hour show, Edie.
Wife,
okay. Suzanne, she says the wife took care of the house and kids. Agree or disagree?
Agree.
It is the wife. You get the first square.
I thought you were trying to trick
me.
What an ordeal.
Okay, Lisa, make your move.
Jamie Widows, please. Mm.
Jamie.
Are you sure about this, Lisa? Mm-hmm. Okay.
What animal does cashmere come from? Is it from a sheep, from a goat, or from a cashmere?
A stud bull.
It's from a goat.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Lisa, he feels that it's self-evident that cashmere comes from a goat. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
It does come from a goat. You should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square.
Oh. He's got the Argyle sweater.
Do I know my fashion?
He
or
does,
what?
But I thought, okay,
Suzanne, you're in business. Make your move.
Marty, please.
Marty to win.
Here we go. I'll take care of you, Suzanne. Trust me on this one.
Marty, you're in a room with 20 divorced women.
Yeehaw!
Okay. Woo! Oh, that's not all. Okay.
I'm afraid he can't concentrate now, Suzanne. You're in a room with 20 divorced women, Marty. Uh-huh. According to the Woman's Almanac, how many of them will tie the knot again? 5 of them, 10 of them, or 15 of them?
Remember your college major.
No, because I happen to have majored in sociology, so I know this. with a minor in divorcees. 5, 10, or 20. I will say...
5, 10, or 15.
15, I'm sorry. And because... and there are 50. I mean, there are 20.
So you're in a room with 20 divorced women.
Wait, let me do this. 25%, 50%, or 75% of them is what you're asking me, you see? Because I also majored in math once. And
at a point.
I would say that indeed, probably... only half get remarried. I will say 10.
So you will say 10 of them will get remarried. Agree or disagree, Suzanne, for the game?
I'll agree.
The answer is 15 of them. No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you.
That's it, Marty. I want a divorce.
Okay, Lisa, you survived. Pick a square for me.
Gloria Loring, please.
Gloria.
Okay, I'm here.
Will you get more calcium from an ounce of cottage cheese or an ounce of milk chocolate?
You will definitely get more calcium from an ounce of cottage cheese.
She says you get more calcium from cottage cheese than milk chocolate. Agree or disagree with that, Lisa?
I agree.
You get more calcium from milk chocolate. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square.
Oh, I see. Sounded real logical.
Okay, Suzanne, you're hanging in there.
I know.
Pick a celebrity for me.
Brian.
Oh, boy.
Brian to win.
This is my first one.
Brian to win. Here we go.
Thank you.
Yeah. Brian to win. According to the book Life Extension, having which of these means you are likely to have a heart attack? A deep crease in your earlobe or a growing brown spot above your navel?
Yuck.
Well, I have a deep crease in my ear. No, but seriously. A deep crease in your earlobe.
Right.
Or a brown spot.
A growing brown spot.
A growing brown spot. Above your navel?
Mm-hmm.
Do you worry about a heart attack if you have a growing brown spot above your...
Either one is...
I would
Brian.
Say...
Show it to us,
Brian. Because you're so worried about that spot, you have a heart attack.
Yes, that's what it is. But, you know, I'll say...
Yes.
Good night, mother.
You'll say good night to Carol Burnett's husband, right?
Yeah. I'll say the ear. That I think it's the earlobe, actually. I do, because
okay.
The body has...
Yes.
See?
Suzanne, he says that a deep crease in your earlobe means you're more likely to have a heart attack. For the game, agree or disagree?
I agree.
It is a deep crease in your earlobe. You're right to agree. You win the game. And now we have a tight match going because it's $500 to Lisa and $425 for Suzanne. Let's clear the board. We're going to move on to our next game. Lisa, you lost the last one. You get to start this one.
I'll take Edie, please.
Again with
what
Edie.
What a surprise. Edie, you're the average teenage girl.
Okay, so like I am, okay? Okay, so, okay.
Shall I stop there?
Okay.
According to a 17 magazine survey, what would you rather be when you grow up? A model, a veterinarian, or a computer programmer?
Okay, so like a model is like real tall and real thin, okay? Okay, so like a veterinarian, it works with sick animals and maybe gets icky stuff on their hands, okay? Okay, so like, and then like, okay, the last thing is like a computer programmer, and like, we are in the age of the computer, and so, okay, like I'm gonna say a computer programmer.
Yeah. For sure. Awesome. Okay, Lisa, she says that most teenage girls would rather be a computer programmer than those other things. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
It is a computer programmer. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the first square in this game.
Teenagers are not dumb, okay?
And that bell means time is up. With $500, our defending champion is once again our winner, Lisa Gold. Congratulations. Go over there. I see you know where to go with Gene Rayburn and get set for the big money. Suzanne, you're really coming on with a rush there at the end. Only time thwarted you. Congratulations. You're a great player. You're leaving here with our thanks and $450.
Thank you very much.
And now, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Here we are with a champ. We congratulate her, and we'll be back with our 9 celebrities and a go at the big money right after this.
Now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Alrighty, here we go. Lisa Gold, you're creeping up there. You now have a total of $3,100, and it's time now for the big money super match, where you can win up to $30,000. Shall we?
Yes.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, and we said, give us your best response to this. Blank Collins. If you remember, the top answer is worth $1,000, the second most popular $500, and the third answer pays $250. You ding before I said it. Now, that's the last time I'm going to tell you. Enough dinging! $250. Now, you can enlist the aid of any 3 of our 9 celebrities here to give you suggestions. Who do you want to call on?
Edie, please.
I'll say Big Tom Collins.
Tom Collins is Edie's response.
Richard.
The Dynasty. Joan.
Joan Collins, all right.
How about Brian?
I'll say Gary Collins.
Gary Collins. It was your big chance, Brian.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you said Gary Collins. All right, so those are the 3, Tom, Joan, and Gary. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own and use that if you wish. What's your pleasure?
I'll say Joan Collins.
Joan Collins of Dynasty, all right. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $250 response? Gary Collins is Brian's response. All right, Joan is the one we're looking for. May we see the $500 response? Tom Collins? All right, so you got 2 of the 3. I think it's a good omen for you, Lisa. Let's take a look at the $1,000 response. Yeah! You have the $1,000. You're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. That means you're going to be playing, well, let's find out right now. Each star has in front of him a hidden number, a 10, a 20, or a 30. If you pick a star with a 10, we'll multiply your money by a 10. If your star is a 20, we'll multiply your money by 20. And there's one star up there and only one with a 30. And if you pick that star, you'll play for 30 times your money, or $30,000. Time now to make your pick.
Lydia Cornell, please.
All right, Lydia. She's chosen you.
Open the thing, right?
Ready, set, go. 8-10. That means you're playing the head-to-head for 10 times $1,000 or $10,000. Here we go. Good luck to you. This is it. All right. Eddie Blank. All right, Lydia, you're going to write your response, and she'll give us a verbal response later. Eddie Blank, E-D-D-I-E, Eddie Blank. When When you're finished, put it in the slot. All right. Your job is to match her for $10,000. How do you do that?
Eddie Fisher?
Eddie Fisher, she says, will match her for $10,000. Lydia, what do you say?
I had Eddie Murphy.
Eddie Murphy. A little more current name. All right. You picked up another $1,000, Lisa, and at this moment you have $4,100, and you have a chance to win more because you're still the current champ. We'll see what happens right after this. Here we are with the current champ, Lisa, who now is $4,100. And John, we're all curious. Just, you want to make a little nickel bet here and tell me who do you think has the 30?
Sure, I'm going to bet on Brian.
I'm betting on Marty. All right, would all of you reveal them at the same time together? Ready, set, go. Marty had it. You owe me a nickel.
Hey, all right. My show pants.
All right, I'll collect later. No, that please. Ends today's session of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. We'll be back tomorrow with our champion here and all nine celebrities. I'll be here for the Match Game.
I'll be here for Hollywood Squares.
So long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Thank you.
Will receive quasars, microwave oven, computes cooking times and power settings automatically in the Instamatic oven. Also defrost by time or weight, furnished by Quasar. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Productions.